Hello children, today I am starting the second chapter in accountancy, that is reconstitution of partnership firm. Reconstitution of partnership. What do you mean by reconstitution? Reconstitution means that the end of existing partnership, it is a now new partnership has formed. If there are four cases in which partnership can form in new way, four, reconstitution of partnership in four ways. First is admission of a partner. When any new partner coming in the old partnership, at that time, reconstitution of partnership. Now, one thing I would like to tell you, that there is a huge difference between dissolution of partnership firm and dissolution of partnership. Dissolution of partnership firm means that the end of business, that we will study in the last chapter. But this is the dissolution of partnership. Means partnership is dissolving, but the new partnership now reconstitute. When any partner admit any new partner is coming in the old partnership, that is the admission of a partner, at that time reconstitution of the partnership exists. In the second point, retirement of a partner, second form of the reconstitution is the retirement of a partner. When any partner retires from the partnership firm, at that time also reconstitution of the partnership exists. In the third form, death of a partner. Very unfortunate if any partner dies in the running business, at that time also new partnership forms. It is the reconstitution of partnership. Okay. Fourth and last point, that is amalgamation of two partnership firms. This is the last part of reconstitution of partnership. That is amalgamation. What do you mean by amalgamation? When two partnership firm running in business of same quality, at that time when they merge each other, when they amalgamate each other, when they combine each other, at that time we call amalgamation of two partnerships. At that time also, reconstitution of the partnership exists. These are the four points that we have to study in this. Means when the admission of a partner, when the retirement of the partner, when the death of the partner, and amalgamation of the two partnerships. Means these three points, first three, are very important. This is in your syllabus. We will study, it's a different chapter also, when new partner admit in a running business, when a partner retire or dies, the death of a partner. Means these are the things that you have to study. And reconstitution. What do you mean by reconstitution? As earlier I told you, that all the things in the business, means all the assets, all the liabilities of the partnership firm, that have to reconstitute, reanalyze in the business. That is called reconstitution. Whenever anything happened among these four, reconstitution happens. Means all the assets and all the liabilities of the firm have to reanalyze again by the old partners whenever it happens. Okay, in the next point I will tell you the later. Thank you. Now, earlier I have explained about the reconstitution of partnership. Four ways that I have explained. Now today I will explain you next topic, that is sacrifice ratio and gaining ratio. Sacrifice ratio and gaining ratio. Students, thing is that whenever new partner admits, old partners, one or two or all old partners have to sacrifice some things. Then only the new partner will get the ratio of profit and loss. That is a main thing. Whenever any partner admission of a new partner. First point that I earlier told you about the admission of a new partner. Whenever new partner admits in the partnership firm, old partner have to sacrifice. One old partner or two old partner or all old partners have to sacrifice. Then only the new partner will get the ratio. Say for example, two partners A and B, they were sharing profit and loss 1:1, means equally. A 1/2 and B 1/2. And C partner admits in the partnership and they agreed to share equally. Then 1:1:1 means A share will be 1/3, B share will be 1/3 and C also 1/3. Then only they will get. How it comes? Means they have to sacrifice. Because earlier denominator was 2, now it is 3. Because 3 partners are there. Means A and B sacrificed for C. Now the question is that how to calculate sacrifice ratio? Because next topic that I will explain about the goodwill, later on I will explain you, no doubt. But first of all, we have to understand that how we calculate sacrifice ratio. That is, there is a formula of that. Means sacrifice ratio formula is old ratio minus new ratio. This is the formula to calculate sacrifice ratio. A was getting earlier 1/2. Now he is getting 1/3. Old ratio was 1/2. Now his ratio is 1/3, means old minus new. We will get the sacrifice of A. Means, now it is, you understand that to calculate sacrifice ratio, we have to take LCM. 2 and 3, LCM is 6. Okay. 2 3s are, so 3 1s are 3. 3 2s are, 3 2s are 6, 2. So, 1 upon 6 sacrificed by A. This is the calculation, general mathematics, that LCM we have taken. 2 and 3, LCM is 6. 2 divided to 6, that is 3 will come. 3 multiplied by 1, 3 will come. And 3, 2s are 6, so 2. 3 minus 2, 1 upon 6. 1 upon 6 sacrificed by A partner. Same way, we calculate B also. B was also getting earlier. B was also getting earlier 1 upon 2. Now B also getting 1 upon 3. The same way B will come 1 upon 6. So both A and B sacrifice 1 upon 6. 1 upon 6. 1 upon 6. 1 upon 6. They both sacrifice, and that way C is getting his ratio. This is the calculation of sacrifice ratio. In the next point, we will learn gaining ratio. Okay? Good. Bye. Last time I told you about the sacrifice ratio. Now, gaining ratio. How to calculate gaining ratio? In the same way, just it's a vice versa formula, that in the sacrifice formula that I told you, that old minus new ratio. Here, new minus new ratio minus old ratio. This is the formula of gaining ratio. Actually, students, why it is necessary to calculate sacrifice and gaining ratio? Because we are learning the reconstitution of partnership firm. In reconstitution of partnership firm, I told you the four types of that method by which we have to calculate reconstitution. Means at the time when any partner admit, at the time when any partner retire, at the time any partner dies, or last amalgamation of two partnership firms. Means whenever partner is admitting, sacrifice ratio will come. And when retirement or death happens in the partnership firm, we have to calculate the gaining ratio. Because his share that the retire of a partner or death of a partner, death of a retire of a partner and death of a partner, one and same thing actually, because in these two cases, retirement and death, partner leaves his share in the partnership. And the other partner, remaining partner, will carry the business. And if they carry the business, definitely his share will distribute among O, means continuing partner, that we say. So at that time we have to calculate gaining ratio, new minus old. New ratio of those partner, those are running business after the retirement or death of a partner. So they will gain something, definitely. Because retired partner or death partner, that leaving is share, and his share will go to the continuing partner. So continuing partner will gain something, definitely. At that time, we have to calculate the gaining ratio, no problem. So gaining ratio formula is new ratio minus old ratio. Now, coming to the next topic, children, pay attention. That is goodwill. Actually, this is a separate chapter. In fact, this is a very wide and vital chapter. What do you mean by goodwill? First of all, I would like to tell you the meaning of goodwill. Goodwill, by one word, if I want to say, that is called reputation of a business. Reputation. In Hindi, we say khyati. It is intangible asset. Nobody can see. And by the running business, partners gain their reputation in the market. When they gain the reputation in the market, that is called their goodwill. Say, for example, I want to say you that Ambani is running the business and he is supposed manufacturing one soap. His soap in the market, suppose MRP of his soap is 20 rupees per piece. And the same quality of the soap that the other business, same quality, unbranded, that he is manufacturing and he is selling 15 rupees. And Ambani getting 20 rupees. So the difference of this 5 rupees, that is Ambani's goodwill. Very short example that I have given you. You just understand what is goodwill. Goodwill, nobody can see. In the next topic, we will learn goodwill. Because reconstitution of the partnership firm, we have to study this topic, goodwill. So, thank you.